Pompeo Coppini emigrated to America from Italy in 1896 and arrived with practically nothing, including any knowledge of the English language. Like most arrivals, impending starvation was part of a stark greeting to those who sought the streets paved with gold. Soon his fortune and abilities played to his favor, and soon he was communicating in English and working as an apprentice for many of the sculptors in New York City. His break came when he volunteered to design a parade float for the Greater New York Carnival. Working through the bitter cold at night by oil torches in a coal yard, he and a friend garnered first place and captured the necessary attention to start a career in a competitive immigrant environment in a very competitive city. After years of working for others, he learned about new opportunities for commissions in Texas and cast his fate there. He stepped off the train in San Antonio and into a new light that was much like his former homeland. San Antonio's light and architecture reminded him of his life in Italy. Coppini soon became a critically acclaimed sculptor with works located throughout the United States, Mexico, and Italy. Many area works, like the Littlefield Fountain at the University of Texas, were notable steps to his rise in the art world. Locally, other sculptures include beloved works of art, including the Scottish Rite Doors in San Antonio, the Express News Relief over their main entrance. Most notable was the Alamo Cenotaph. He even sculpted his own tomb at Sunset Memorial here in San Antonio, where he, his wife, and their adopted daughter, Waldine Tao, rest. In 1891, Fiesta began with a simple parade around the Alamo Circle of horseless carriages, decorated with fresh flowers. The ladies who organized the event threw flower petals from automobiles to commemorate the victory of the Texans at the Battle of San Jacinto. These were the origins of the Battle of Flowers Parade. Coppini's goal was as a historical preservationist to expand the single celebration to a week-long citywide party in commemoration of the city's history. In 1904, Coppini turned down a commission for a sculpture of Davy Crockett for a new hotel that was to compete with the Menger Hotel on the Alamo grounds. Coppini knew that they wanted to build on the sacred ground, so he immediately went to Aldina de Zavala, and together they went to talk to Clara Driscoll about purchasing the property to save the Alamo grounds. Coppini's next step was to create an organization, the Chili 13, comprised of artists and aristocrats with the function to promote projects for the good of the town. A carnival was added to the April Battle of Flowers Parade in 1905, and later the first night parade and the first royal court. Coppini then designed the first Fiesta medal. He and the lady from the court modeled for this medal, and it was inscribed K of O, Knights of Omala, which is Alamo spelled backwards. To thank Clara Driscoll for her role in saving the Alamo grounds, Coppini made her the first queen. Coppini was referred to as the father of Fiesta. San Antonio now realizes how a poor Italian immigrant turned world-class artist would come to shape the traditions of our beautiful city.
I think that when he passed away, he didn't really have that much money. He was in his 80s, and he and Mrs. Coppini were living here. They passed away within the year together. And his adopted daughter, their adopted daughter, Waldine Tosh, took over. For instance, Mrs. McNay had a lot of resources. She also had a very large collection of modern art from other prominent artists. She herself was an artist, but she had the mansion over in Alamo Heights, and she had resources to continue that legacy. Whereas after the Coppinis died, Waldine Tosh continued it just with classes here, and it never really took on the status because of the physical location. This place is very small, and then not that much money was left to continue it. So people, like, especially in the Italian community, they know about Coppini, other artists and sculptors. We have visitors I went to a reception at the art museum with the Italian ambassador. People do know about him, but it should be prominent on our on the tourist roster, and it's not. And I think it's because location, and then also it's run by members. I mean, we really need funding because all of this work is just volunteer. So to really take off, we'd need massive advertising. We would need a lot of resources, brochures, a gift shop. We'd have more children's tours, school groups. It should be on the convention center roster too, so that people come here. But it's just always been in the hands of very faithful members, and that's hard.
Coppini's final legacy to his adopted homeland was the Coppini Academy of Fine Arts, located at 115 Melrose Place, where the Alamo Cenotaph was created. Coppini believed strongly that classical art will save humanity from the chaos of the world, and he wanted to leave behind a place where artists could meet to continue the tradition of classical representational art through discussions, demonstrations, life drawing, classes, and workshops. To this day, artists are welcome into his studio at 115 Melrose Place, which is kept alive by San Antonio artists and volunteers.